That's right.
We're going to call a spade a goddamn spade.
That's right.
He hired them. He hired them to suppress us. We're speaking up for you. Listen to what I'm telling you now. Pay attention. They were hired by him to suppress us so we wouldn't talk to you.
But they burnt it down.
Exactly. Now watch this. Watch this. We're pushing for reparations. Come on, reparations is the black call today. Reparations. Reparations is given for a crime committed against the people that have been disenfranchised, disenchanted, oppressed, repressed, and suppressed. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
So, when we talk about reparations, let's add it up. What does America owe black people? What does Tulsa owe? What does white Tulsa owe black Tulsa? Let's add it up.
Reparations.
They murdered your fathers. Raped your mothers.
Yes, sir.
Burned you out.
Yes, sir.
And then they want us to get a permit to tell you about it.
Imperialists.
Listen to this. Hegemony. Imperialism.
That's right.
Colonialism.
Talk about it.
Disenfranchisement. And they caught us off into little projects.
They call it politics.
When they call your neighborhood projects, that means that they're working on something on you.
Yeah.
Pay attention.
Why do you think they don't walk around with masks on?
Experimentation.
Because they know. They know. That the virus was genetically coded to attack people who were melanated. But what they did not understand
was
that there's something in our DNA that fights it off anyway. So they created a vaccine. When the virus didn't kill you, they created a vaccine to finish the goddamn job.
Genocide
is the purposeful disenfranchisement of a people. Strategically causes the people to turn in on themselves. They strategically act in their own demise. That's killing each other off. So goddamn it, we don't just charge you for reparations. We charge genocide.
Right.
We charge genocide.
That's right.
The systematic killing off of an entire people.
That's
right. For the profit of another. Goddamn it, we charge genocide. And we're standing in front of this house. And we're not asking for anything. We don't come here asking for reparations. That's a pump position.
That's right.
When a motherfucker owes you something.
That's right.
On your pump sourcing, man. You get a thing with your own. That's a bitch position. A man gonna go tap your motherfucking pockets and take what you owe from.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
If he know you owe him, and you duck it, when he finds you, he coming to get him. So we telling white Tulsa, your day has arrived. We telling white America, your day of oppressing us, killing us off wholesale in the name of law enforcement. Pay attention, goddammit.
That's right.
You murder us wholesale in the streets. You come in our neighborhoods, not as citizens on patrol, goddammit. You come in our neighborhoods as an occupying army.
That's right.
And when an occupying army comes in your neighborhood, they're not coming in to secure you. They're coming in a combative fashion to destroy you.
That's right. That's right.
So what you got right now is a black military saying, bring that shit.
That's right. That's right. Black power.
You're not going to do with us what you did with them yesterday.
Stand up,
Black power. Black power.
Black power. We didn't come here to play tiptoeing through the tulips with you. We ain't come here to say coon about goddamn y'all. We didn't come here just to march through your
your streets and give you a rosy promise of a tomorrow that never did. We came here to stand with you, not to march in your goddamn streets. So we're telling you, when you see us coming through your hood, stand with us.
Yeah.
And let white folks know that there is
hope.
All of you,
New Black Panther
under the sound of my voice,
in the house.
These are your brothers and sisters right here.
That's right.
That's right.
These Panthers, they came all over the country.
Las Vegas.
Las Vegas.
And oftentimes, we love them more than they hate themselves. That's why we stand so goddamn strong.
That's right.
See, this right here, it's not easy for us. But we ain't the kind of people that do what's easy. We challenge what's difficult.
That's okay.
Who ain't Black Lives Matter? Don't get the fucking narrative twisted.
That's right.
But goddamn it, we ain't Black Lives motherfucking Matter. We're telling you. Who is Black Lives Matter? But paid apologists for white oppression. Hand-picked, paid in the back door, apologist for white oppression. Who the fuck did you get money from?
George Soros, a fucking cracker. A fucking cracker.
They're funding Black Lives Matter, but don't think they speak for you. God damn it, you ain't nothing but a dollar sign to them.
That's right, that's right.
So we're going to tell these ambulance chasing attorneys.
That's right.
Whenever a black body drops in the street at the hands of fucking Gestapo troops.
That's right.
We're telling these hand-picked hirelings, these goddamn lawyers, Benjamin Crump, that agent rat-ass Al Sharpton, and all
right.
The rest of them bastards.
That's right.
We're telling you,
that stitch Al Sharpton.
You cannot. You cannot
the snitch on the Gambino crime family.
You cannot, under any circumstances, put a price on black life.
That's right.
So when they say, well, at least he got a nice settlement, ask that bastard how much his child's worth. Before you go and ask for a settlement for the death of one of mine, goddammit, how much is your child worth?
That's right.
That's right.
If your babies are priceless, why the fuck would you try to negotiate a price for mine?
Absolutely. That's right.
Know who your enemies are.
That's right.
Know who your enemies are.
That's right.
Know who your enemies are. Know who your goddamn enemies are. We know we got paid agents out here. We know we got rats out here.
Absolutely.
We know we got snitches out here.
Absolutely.
We got agents out here.
That's right. That's right.
Be telling you your day coming.
Yeah.
We know we got agents in the press. I ain't here for a motherfucking press conference. You don't
That's
ask
right.
me for an interview.
That's right. That's right.
You point that
That's
out.
Right. That's right.
You didn't get my words right when I was in Carolina. So I don't trust you to get them right today.
Yeah.
I'm not calling for a press conference. I don't need one of them.
That's right.
I need to talk to you.
That's right.
I don't give a damn about talking
That's
to him.
Right.
I want to talk to my goddamn parents. This is a family affair.
That's right.
This is a goddamn family reunion right here.
That's right.
All of us are brothers and sisters.
That's right.
All of us are brothers and sisters. This is a family reunion. Them bastards never thought they'd see. They thought when they killed our parents, our grandparents, burned them out, they thought that we would not resurrect this shit. But we're telling you, we ain't talking about Nazareth, goddammit. We're telling you the resurrection is a fact.
That's right.
Look at these black bodies that you thought were dead and worthless and lifeless. They're coming to life, goddammit. They're coming to life. Lord, dry bones in that valley. So this is the valley of decision.
Thousand people.
Pay attention. This is the valley of decision. In Black Tulsa, you are called to make a decision today. Once you have heard the truth, I got it.
Stand up, Tulsa.
Once you have heard the truth, you have a responsibility to act on the truth that you hear. You have a responsibility to act on the truth that you hear. When you hear right knowledge, I ain't talking about knowledge that falls down and is good for nothing. I'm talking
about when you hear right knowledge. They call that life-giving teaching. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad, through the voice of Khalid Abdul Muhammad, told them a while back that non-revolution is just about talk. Pay attention. I want you to pay very close attention to what I have to say.
Yes, sir.
Because I ain't just come to talk, to shake hands and hug bodies. I came to talk to shake this motherfucker up.
That's right.
That's right.
That's
right.
That's why I came here.
That's right.
Shake it up. Break it up.
That's right.
Break up. And stay woke. I want y'all to hear from my brother.
You already said.
Black power!
Black power!
Black power!
Black power!
Black power!
Black power!
Black power! Black power! Black power! We will not let them stop us! We will not let them stop us! This is the torch that we gotta keep running with!
We gotta keep running with it!
We can't wait to every 100 years to come to this day. We got to live like this every day. We got to keep this energy every day. I done gave you this speech a whole lot of time, and I love to give it when I'm around a lot of people just like this, because it needs to be heard. We dropped the torch.
That's right.
We have got to pick back up the torch.
That's right.
Let me ask somebody. What did Rosa Parks do? Harriet Tubman do?
They stood against oppression. They stood against death, drugs, and opposition.
Man, what did Harriet Tubman do?
Why? She led us to freedom. She made a way for us out of nowhere.
What did Harriet Tubman do? Chief of Staff, tell them what Harriet Tubman did was most important to what we're going to get to today.
She picked somebody up and she took them with her. She went back and got somebody else.
She went and got somebody.
Each one teach
me. Now go get somebody.
Each one
go
teach
get
me.
Somebody. Hey, go get somebody! Go get somebody! We got to go and get somebody! You hear me? We all come here today, and one thing we say about this generation we got today, what we always say, this generation we in today is up! Is that what we say? Well, how are we gonna let them? How are we gonna leave them up in it?
Come on.
How you go? Yeah, we say today that this generation is fucked up. So how we gonna leave these children up in it? We ain't picking nobody up. We are not holding each other accountable.
We gotta do this for them.
Yo, we gotta get these thugs off our streets.
Let's
in 1866, the new Black Panther Party was started. By two college students by the name of Harry P. Newton and Bobby Seale.
Speak their names. Speak their names.
Fellas that decided that they wanted to make a difference. They was tired about Wall Street being burnt down. They were tired about churches being burnt down. They were tired about kids being raped. Drugs in our community. So you know what they did? Let's join the movement. Let's start a party.
That's right.
And the Panthers did that.
That's right.
The Panthers did that. But you know what?
Black power. Black power.
The enemy didn't like the fact that when the Panthers stepped up.
They thought the Panthers was dead.
Now, they did a research, okay? Many of you all don't know who we are today, but it's insanity to us if we come to your city and come back and you ain't one of us.
Join the Panthers.
It's insanity, fellas. We all say we know somebody that's body, body. Everybody knows somebody that's body, body. He with it.
Working on his document.
Yeah.
The daughter of Black Panther.
Yeah.
Did the way for you, you know.
That's right.
Some of us, we're the Panthers.
That's correct. And this, absolutely. And this is what I want to say today. today. They did research. Things were still happening in our community. That still were police brutality. So they did a research and come to find out all the Panthers were knocked out. There were nowhere to be found. The FBI said that the Panthers were the bad guys. Many of you have the dream of the way to the way to the way. They love me.
Come on, Toast! afraid to organize. Stop molesting. Get up. Stand up. Stand up for your rights. Don't give up the fight. Y'all know how many people we lost right here on this field? Do y'all know? Yeah, we got to do better, man. We got to do better, people. I know it's more people that want to go in the moment than that right now.
About 5:30.
I know it's more. Mm-hmm. You see how those cameras are running? You see how the crowd cleared up?
We started to post the
truck. Because we ain't just a puppet hype show.
I'll be here tomorrow. You come to the jump for the arm rally?
We organized it. And we had developments.
Talk started too. Started too. I was going to go home. I'm just going to be coming back tomorrow. I'm going to bring a whole family Sunday. They're doing a big rally Sunday.